Nowadays, everything is information-centric. Data has enormous hidden values which have to be unlocked by advanced engineering techniques and create impacts to the society. Through data generation and measurement by sensors, data transmission and networking to connect people and objects, coupled with advanced data processing algorithms and analytics, and data can be enhanced into forward-looking information and predictions. Together with the added value of system and network security, we can realize many useful internet and artificial intelligence applications and achieve the goal of a smart world.
現在很多時候的程式都會是支援流動支付，但是誰會寫程式的呢？ Apple 的 CEO Tim Cook 都講過，其實現在可能是一個九歲的小孩就已經可以寫一隻App出來了。網絡保安方面其實最重要的就是由根源開始，開頭設計一個系統或者寫程式的時候，學生應該要受到紮實的訓練。
在2019年呢個暑假，我參加咗呢個 UG Summer Research Internship 啦，好榮幸可以攞到呢個 Best Project Award。我呢個 project 咧就係關於 security 同埋 machine learning。我哋就係用呢個 trust process 去實現 secure machine learning，就係喺做 machine learning 嘅同時，確保啲 data
唔會被洩漏出去。喺讀書嘅時候，我已經好中意用唔同嘅技術解決生活上各種嘅問題。 當時咧，我同一志同道合嘅同學一齊參加咗各類型嘅比賽，亦都攞咗相當唔同嘅成績。喺畢業之後，我入咗科學院，繼續我研發之旅。我相信喺未來呢10年，對於信息工程嘅同學仔係一個非常巨大嘅機遇。大數據、物聯網、人工智能呢啲都係未來影響住人類非常巨大嘅技術關鍵。
個私隱度同嗰個方便性咧，都會係一個繼續互相要平衡嘅觀點嚟嘅。而家我哋講緊就話 Internet of Things， 即係物聯網嘅世界。但去到5G嘅世界，有啲人已經講緊係話 Internet of Everything， 含曬你嘅背後嘅 database， 將佢 personalize 咗，變咗係適合你使用嘅產品或者你嘅服務。咁呢啲當然係有好大嘅方便性，但係亦都涉及到就係私隱啦。 咁所以呢兩者點樣攞個平衡呢？我相信嚟緊都會係一個好大嘅要繼續討論題目嚟嘅。好希望咧能夠將
IE 學到嘅知識咧貢獻翻俾呢個社會，譬如應用 IoT 即係物聯網技術咧，去幫助一啲有智力障礙啊、有其他發展障礙嘅小朋友掌握語言嘅。 Cloud AAC System 發展成為一個叫通話儀嘅系統，2019年嘅5月就正式喺耀能協會裏面投入內部運作㗎啦。
In many cases, we are not aware that users may or may not value certain information. The successful engineering system not only needs to be technology advanced, but also needs to consider of psychology, of economics, and sometimes policy issues. So for our information engineering students, they're really important to broaden their scope, have an interdisciplinary academic background, so that when they go to the real world design systems, the system can be more successful.